in life. Just to stand for my God. Just to stand for my God. And heal in life.
I'm being reminded of the story of Peter. When Jesus was walking on water, he was with Peter. When Peter wanted Jesus to prove himself that he's really Jesus, when they were on the lake, Peter said, "If you're really the Son of God, let me walk on this water." And indeed, Peter walked on the water. But something happened. He just changed his focus. He used to focus on Jesus when he was like, I want to know if it is really you, let me walk on this water. But something happened. He forgot that Jesus is there, that was the focus. And he decided to look around. And what he saw was a very big storm. A very, very big storm. And it brought fear unto him. And he started sinking. And that is where most of us as sons we are. From the beginning, our focus was Jesus. Then diseases came. We heard of coronavirus. We decided to change our focus. And now sons are sinking. All they are seeing is that they lost their job. All they are seeing is that they don't have anything to eat. All they are seeing is that they can die any minute. They've decided that it's now YOLO. You'll only live one. People, allow me to say this. Remove that rubbish from you. Remove that rubbish from your head. You not only just live once, but you live in Christ.
Amen.
He was the focus from before, and he's your focus until now.
Yes.
No matter the storm that you're seeing, no matter that thing that you see, that's very big thing, that now I can't do it. You've just said, I don't have a work, I don't have anything. You've just allowed yourself depression to kill you slowly and slowly and slowly. You're just thinking of so many ways to kill yourself. You're going nowhere. You're here to stay with us. And you're here to manifest Christ.
Amen.
And here I am speaking. I'm speaking an awakening of the mind. That mind that decided that it's not depression will kill it. May it have a revival this moment.
Jesus' name.
May it have a revival this moment. I speak an awakening of the Spirit. I speak an awakening of the Spirit. Let them see you, Jesus, once again. Be their focus once again. Show them, O dear Lord, that you're there to carry their burdens. You died on the cross because you love them so much. And it's not their part to die. They can't die for you. You already did that for us. Mm-hmm. That's not our portion. So yes, this depression that is killing people, it is defeated this moment in Jesus' name. It is defeated this moment. Yes. That frustration that is making you sleepless, that distress that you can't even sleep, turning to your love to nafikiria rent, ukitani sendingine, you're just thinking of other things. No, that is not our focus. Our focus is Christ.
Yes.
And he has never let anyone down. All through the Bible, I've read all the stories. I've not seen my God turn anyone down. My Father has never let anyone down. Who told you you'll be the first one? Who told you you'll be the first one to experience him failing someone? You won't be. He's a faithful God. His promises are ever true. If he said he'll be with you, he's with you right now. He will never leave you. Whether you feel like he's far away, whether you feel like you're broken, whether you feel like you can't do it, whether you feel like you're on your own, that's your mind, that's your feelings talking. My God said that I'll be with you and I will never leave you nor forsake you. When he said that, he meant it.
Yes.
And he has never failed on his promises.
Yes.
So he won't fail until he won't fail you this moment. He won't fail you this moment. Just give thanks unto him for the peace that he has already given you.
Amen.
We are now not talking about frustration and distress. That's not your story to talk about. We've already sent it to the cross of Christ.
Yes.
We already sent it to our Father. Yes. Now he's telling you, come unto my arms. I want to give you rest. Come unto my arms and I want to give you joy. May you find joy in the house, in the hands of God. May you find joy in the presence of God. Pray for the peace of God to reign over you. Thank God for the joy. Thank God for the joy. Thank God for the happiness. You are above that feeling. You are above that distress. You are above that frustration. Thank you, Jesus.
Take it, Lord.
Praise God. And Father, we thank you for you have heard us.
Yes, Lord.
God, you said we come unto you and you give us rest. Yes. Your sons have approached you, God. And I thank you, Father, for you've already given them rest, Jesus, Father. Jesus. I speak the peace, oh dear Lord, in their lives, yes. Father. Just as Paul was happy even when in lack and when in plenty, God, that is the peace I'm speaking unto your sons in this moment. That even in their distress, they won't think you're far away, Father. They'll feel you, oh dear Lord, that you're more closer to them than ever. God, in Colossians 1:27, you say that we are the hope of glory. Christ in us. Christ in us, God. Let that be our revival any moment. That I won't get depressed because I no longer live, but Christ lives in me. And my Jesus has never been depressed, so I won't be the first one to be. Frustration is not our portion in Jesus' name. Distress is not our portion in Jesus' name. We have peace in our Christ. We have peace in Jesus. We have peace in Jesus. And may you receive that peace right this moment. You who feel that you're weary, you're weary. Your morning, you just see death left, right, and center. I speak the comfort of God right here. I speak the peace of God right here. You have rest in Jesus. He loves you very much. Even when you are prodigal, he still had his arms open. That anytime you decide to turn back, he's willing to open his arms and embrace you. So don't feel that you're far away because you're not part of the sheep or part of the flock. That's not your portion. Whether you're a prodigal, whether you're not, you're still the son of my Father. And he loves you just as he loves everyone else. And his love is so overwhelming. It's a very endless love. He wants to shower you with that love this moment. May you feel the love of the Father right now. May you feel the embrace of God right this moment.
Jesus.
May you feel the abundance of his peace.
Thank
you, Jesus. We worship you, God. And we glorify your holy name. Usikia e maombi. Ujibuye kwa moto. Yupo Mungu mbinguni ayajibu.